Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech Social This Side, and this is continuation of Azure tutorial. So today we are going to see about the different ways to use the SQL on Azure. If you haven't watched last two videos of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch part 8 and part 9 of this video series, so where you can understand about the Azure SQL and Azure SQL databases, the basic concept of all those, and how we can create and set up inside the Azure. So let's get started with this video. So as I have already explained you that we can use the Azure SQL in three different ways. The first, which is SQL Server on Azure VM. Second is the Azure SQL Managed Instance. And last is the Azure SQL Databases. So as you can see, this is for the infrastructure as service, and this is platform as service. So inside the platform as service, Azure SQL database, and inside the infrastructure as service, SQL Server on Azure VM. So this is for the best for lift and shift of workloads require 100% SQL Server compatibility as OS level access. So on that level, we can use the SQL Server on Azure VM. Second is the Azure SQL Managed Instance. So this is best for the modernization existing app. And last for the Azure SQL database, which is platform as service. So this is best for the modern cloud applications. So go to the next slide and we'll try to use which is good over all these. So here we'll be going to see the difference between Azure SQL Managed Instance and Azure VM. The first is the serverless, second is the managed instance, and last is the SQL VM. So first is good for the single database, and second, here we can see the managed instance. So this is best for the migration to cloud, and this is best for migration to cloud. So this is good for the single database, and this is good for the while we are going to migrate to cloud. Second, we can see the Elastic Pool we can use here. Elastic Pool we can use, and here we can use the lift and shift option. Next, we can use database server. Here we can also use the database server, and here can be moved without any changes. So we can move the database without any changes. Next is the migration is hard for the serverless, and here migration is also hard for the managed instance. And here we can see can choose when start maintenance, patching, change and recovery model. Next, we can see few SQL Server features are not available here in case of the serverless, and also in case of the managed instance, few SQL Server features are not available, but here those are available inside the SQL VM. Here we can see the backup and patches are managed, so these can be managed here. And database up to 100 TB. So this will be the database size could be, and up to 99.995% accuracy in case of the serverless. And in case of the managed instance, the backup and packages are managed, and database could be up to 100 TB. And again, it would be 99.995%. And in case of SQL VM, this can be caused the service, and this will be highly customizable, and it will be accepted downtime while making the changes to storage CPU, and it will be up to the 256 TB storage, and which is very more than the managed instance and serverless option. And next, it will be 99.99%. As you can see the availability. As per your requirement, you can either choose the serverless option, or we can use the managed instance, or we can choose the SQL VM. So these are the main features that we can use between serverless, managed instance and SQL VM. So I hope guys you have understand when we can use one or other. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you really like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. See you in the next video.